हेलो बच्चों, वेलकम बैक टू योर फेवरेट यूट्यूब चैनल लर्निंग साइंस विद सीके। बच्चों, एज वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द फर्स्ट चैप्टर एंड ऑलरेडी वी हैव स्टार्टेड द सेकंड चैप्टर न्यूट्रिशन इन एनिमल्स एंड फर्स्ट पार्ट इज ऑलरेडी पब्लिश्ड एंड हियर इन द लास्ट चैप्टर यू हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द वेरियस मोड ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन इन एनिमल्स। ओके, एंड अंडर इट वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट the feeding habit in different types of animals. Then we got to study about the amazing fact, and here we studied about starfish, the special type of feeding habit of starfish. Then we have started digestion in humans, we humans. Okay, and we get to know that how digestion takes place in human beings, and we get to know all the parts, body parts name of especially of digestive system, all the compartments name we get step by step. And after that we have started to study every compartment in detail, and in the last video we have covered two compartments. First was mouth and buccal cavity. Here we have studied about the arrangement of teeth in our mouth and the role of buccal cavity in digestion. You have also done an activity related with the taste of amylase. There is an enzyme which help in the digestion of starch. We get to know that digestion starts in our mouth. After that, you get to know about the how acids are responsible for the tooth decay. Then we studied about our tongue, and I have asked you a question that you please mention if you know, otherwise search it, that which part of the tongue is responsible for different type of taste. You have done the activity under it, and I have told you to write in comment box. Okay, so some of you have written and some of you have not written, but I am going to tell you the answer of this, and in this video I will tell you the answer. Okay, when I will start. Okay, after studying the tongue, we have studied about the oesophagus. Okay, oesophagus, we studied that how food passes in oesophagus. Now I will start today the stomach. Okay, from the point stomach we will study about the structure of the stomach and how digestion takes place in stomach. Okay, and further compartments we will cover in this video. So be with me in this video, and please open your book and see line by line, step by step we will learn and get all the knowledge. Okay, so come to the book.
Hello bachcho, last day we were studying the nutrition in animal, and we have studied various things under it, and we have also started digestion in human, and here we have studied the various compartments of the digestive system, starting from the buccal cavity and then food pipe and oesophagus. So we have covered buccal cavity. Okay, and under it we have studied about the various types of teeth present in our mouth. Next we have studied about the our tongue, that our tongue has different reasons for taste, and I have asked you a question also, that tell me which reason is responsible for which type of taste. So I am going to tell you today, and answer is that the top reason of the tongue is tasting sweet. Okay, it tastes sweet, and that either side of this region are responsible for salty taste. These two regions are for salty taste, and again after these there are two or more regions are there, and it is for sour taste. Okay, after that in the behind you see this region taste what? Bitter. Okay, I am repeating once again, top part is for sugary taste, sweet taste, Then either side of this top part is for salty taste, okay? And after the other regions, after this is responsible for sour taste, okay? And the behind region, this region is responsible for bitter taste, okay, bachcho? After that, we have started food pipe or esophagus, and you get to know that how food pipe and esophagus is helps in the movement of food to reach stomach, okay? And today we are going to study stomach, and you know stomach, this region, this cup shaped this shape, this region is called stomach, okay? And we will get to know all things about it. So stomach is a big, is a thick walled bag. This is a thick, its wall is very thick, okay bachcho, because acid is released in this bag, and that help in the digestion of food. So this the wall of the stomach is very thick to protect us from the released acid, okay? Then its shape is like a flattened J, and it is the widest part of the alimentary canal, okay? You can compare this the shape of the stomach as it looks like J, okay? And this is the what, this is the widest part of the alimentary canal. Whatever the alimentary canal till we have studied, here you can see the whole structure of the alimentary canal, and here stomach is the biggest region, okay? Next is that it receives food from the food pipe at one end and open into the small intestine at the other, okay? It has two ends, stomach has two ends. First end is attached with esophagus, okay? And the end part is opens into small intestine, okay? You can see here this region goes to small intestine, and the upper part, upper opening is attached with the esophagus. So this is the receiving part, and this is the releasing part of the stomach. Next, the inner lining of the stomach secrete mucus, hydrochloric acid and digestive juice. So three things are being released by the inner lining of the stomach. Mucus help to protect the wall of the stomach, and hydrochloric acid help in the digestion of the food, okay? And other digestive juices are also released for the digestion of various nutrients. The mucus protect the lining of the stomach. As I bachcho, I told you that mucus protect the inner lining of the stomach. So this is the inner lining of the stomach, and this is being protected by the mucus, and those mucus are released from this inner lining, okay? The acid kills many bacteria that enter along with the food and makes the medium in the stomach acidic, okay? So the role of acid is to kill all the bacteria present in the food which are harmful to us, and also it helps and make the medium acidic. And so if anybody asks you that the what is the acidity or what is the pH or acidity of the stomach, then you can tell it is acidic, okay? And this acidic medium help in the digestion. And most of the digestive enzymes, digestive juice which is being released in the stomach, they only work in acidic medium. So acidic medium in the stomach is very important. The digestive juice breaks down the protein into simpler substances. So protein is a complex substance, and these digestive juices which are released from the lining of the stomach help in breakdown of protein into simpler substances, and simpler substances can easily being absorbed by the lining of the intestine. Okay, the next compartment is small intestine. Where is the small intestine in the complete set of digestive system? Here you can see the other end, as I told you earlier, that the other end part of the stomach attached with the intestine, and this region is called small intestine. Okay, this is called small intestine. So we will study about this small intestine. Okay, the small intestine is highly coiled and is about 7.5 meter long. Okay bachcho, the length of the intestine is 7.5 meter. Okay, and it is highly coiled also. Here you have seen how it is coiled. Okay, you can see here how it is coiled. Okay, next is, it receives secretions from the liver. Okay, it receives secretion from the liver and the pancreas. Beside, its wall also secrete juices. So small intestine receives many types of juices, digestive juices. From where? From the liver and from the pancreas. Okay, so these juices help in the digestion. The liver is a reddish brown gland situated in the upper part of the abdomen on the right side. Okay, where is the liver situated? Liver is you want to see the shape of the liver? Here is the liver. You can see here. This is called liver. Okay, so liver is a reddish brown gland situated in the upper part of the abdomen on the right side. So as you have seen, the liver is a reddish brown gland situated in the upper part of the abdomen on the right side. Okay, it is the largest gland in the body. As bachcho, I told you, this is the largest gland in the body. Okay, the glands are those organelles which are releasing enzymes. Okay, they are called glands. It secretes bile juice. So liver is secreting bile juice, and it is stored in a sac called the gallbladder. So I am going to show you the shape of gallbladders. Okay, that is situated in the liver. So here bachcho, you can see that this is the gallbladder. Whatever the bile juice released from this liver is being stored in gallbladder. Okay, so liver is also helping in digestion of food. Next, the bile play an important role in the digestion of fat. Bachcho, the role of bile juice is digestion, helping in the digestion of fat. What happens? This bile juice breaks down the complex fat molecules into simpler forms. Okay, the pancreas is a large green colored gland located just below the stomach. Okay, next gland which help in the digestion is pancreas. Okay, and it is a large cream colored gland. I am going to show you the shape of the pancreas in the digestive system. Here you can see this structure is called pancreas, and it is cream colored organelle. Okay, and this is releasing digestive juice also, and those juices are also helping in digestion. So the pancreatic juice act on carbohydrate, fat and protein. Okay, after the role of bile juice, this pancreas also help in the digestion of what? Carbohydrate, fat and protein. Okay, and changes them into simpler form. Okay, so as carbohydrate, fat and protein are in the complex form, these pancreatic juices help to break these complex substances into simpler forms. Okay,
hello bachcho, one important thing we should know is that the working of the stomach was discovered by a strange accident. Okay, we will get to know how the working of the stomach is being discovered. Okay, what happened in 1822, a man named Alexis Saint Martin. Alexis Saint Martin was a man, and he was an army man. Okay, was badly hit by a shotgun. Okay, okay, Alexis Saint Martin was badly hit by a shotgun. Then what happened? The bullet had seriously damaged the chest wall. Okay, you can see this representative figure, how that shotgun has damaged his chest wall. Okay, here, and made a hole in his stomach. He was brought to an American army doctor, William Beaumont. Okay, William Beaumont was a army doctor who treated Alexis Saint Martin, and Alexis Saint Martin was badly hit by a shotgun which has damaged the chest wall and made a hole in his stomach. This in this representative figure, we can imagine this. This is the region of stomach in our body, and at the middle of this, he was hit by a shotgun which damaged his stomach, made a hole on the stomach also. The doctor saved the patient, but he could not close the hole properly. What happened? That Dr. William Beaumont saved the patient, but he was not able to completely close the hole. Okay, completely close the hole and left it bandaged. What he has done? He bandaged the hole. Okay, Beaumont took it as a great opportunity to see the inside of the stomach. Okay, now something triggered in the mind of the Beaumont that how he can know the functioning of stomach, as he found that a hole is present and easily he can see through the hole. What he observed, that inside the stomach through the hole, he observed that there is churning of food. He was able to see the churning of food by some instrument. Okay, its wall secreted a fluid which could digest the food. He observed that, who observed? Beaumont. Dr. Beaumont observed that the food was digested by some juice which was secreted from the wall of the stomach. He also observed that the end of the stomach opened into the intestine. Okay, he was able to observe that end of the stomach was attached with the intestine or open into intestine. Only after the digestion of the food inside the stomach is completed, means there is a closer muscle here which block the movement of food whenever digestion takes place in the stomach. Okay, when digestion completes in the stomach, then only this door opens and the food enters the small intestine. These things being observed by Dr. Beaumont. Okay, in this way he get to know about the function of stomach, and he told to the whole world about Dr. Beaumont. You have also studied in class 5, as you, if you remember. Okay, now come to the, we were studying the small intestine, functioning of the small intestine. Okay, in a small intestine, we got to know that small intestine is highly coiled and it is about 7.5 meter long, and secretion from liver and pancreas is being received in the small intestine, okay, which help in the digestion. So liver, you know that liver is of which color? Reddish brown color. And where it is situated? It is situated in the upper part of the abdomen, okay, in the right side. And you also stated that this is largest gland in our body, and it secrete bile juice that is stored in the sac, that is called gall bladder, okay. And these bile play help in the digestion of fat. Then you have also studied about pancreas, that is the another gland which secrete digestive juice, and it's a cream colored gland, okay. And pancreatic juice help in the digestion of carbohydrate, fat and protein, okay, and convert the complex carbohydrate, fat and protein into simpler forms. Now what happens? The partly digested food now reaches the lower part of the small intestine, where the intestinal juice completes the digestion of all component of the food, okay. As we have studied that the small intestine is a coiled tubular structure, okay, as you have seen in picture also, that small intestine is a tubular and long structure, okay. After digestion in the stomach, food enters in the small intestine. Here liver and pancreas releases the various types of digestive juice which helps in the digestion, and the whole digestion takes place in this tubular structure, okay, and it's take a long time. Come to the next. Okay, the carbohydrate get broken into simple sugars such as glucose, fat into fatty acid, and glycerol and protein into amino acid. So bachcho, what is the simplest form of carbohydrate? It is sugar and glucose. And what is the simplest form of fat? That is fatty acid and glycerol. And what is the simplest form of protein? It is amino acid. So these breakdown takes place in small intestine, okay. Now absorption in the small intestine. So after the digestion, what is the next function, bachcho? Next function is absorption. Absorption is absorption of nutrient in the blood, okay. So the digested food can now pass into the blood vessel in the wall of the intestine. This process is called absorption, okay. So what is absorption? Absorption is a process of blood vessel, okay. Absorption is the process of passing the nutrients to the blood vessel, okay, through the wall of the intestine. So it is absorption. The inner wall of the small intestine have thousands of finger like outgrowth, and these are called villi, singular villus, okay. We are also going to telling it villi, okay, villi, singular is villus. So villi is you observe your fingers in your hand. As you have fingers in your hand, the same way there are finger like projections in the wall of the small intestine, okay, and that help in the absorption of the digested food. And the singular form of the villi is villus, okay. Now can you guess what the role of villi could be in the intestine? As I told you, bachcho, same absorption. So special feature is that villi increase the surface area for absorption of the digested food. You can understand this by looking towards your fingers and the gap and the surface area how because of fingers the surface area increases, and because of this long and long surface area, food is being absorbed easily. Okay, so each villus has a network of thin and small blood vessels. Okay, each villus has a network of thin and small blood vessels, and blood vessels function is to absorb and carry the nutrient to the various part of the body. Okay, so each villus has a network of thin and small blood vessels close to its surface. Okay, the surface of the villi absorb the digested food material. Okay, so these surface help in the absorption. The absorbed substance are transported via the blood vessel to the different organs of the body, where they are used to build complex substances such as the protein required by the body. So bacho, what we have learned? We have learned that in the wall of the intestine there is a villi, and villi is what? Villi is a finger like projection situated in the wall of the small intestine, and this villi increases the surface area, and all villi contain, they have so many vessels, blood vessels, and these blood vessels and villi main function is absorption of nutrients from the intestinal space. Okay, so these things we have learned here, and these nutrients, whatever is absorbed by the villi, then it goes to the blood, and this is being carried to the different part of the body, where various types of new nutrients are prepared, new types of proteins, new types of substances are prepared, which is required by the body. So this process of making a different type of protein using the absorbed nutrients is called assimilation, making something different that is required by the our body. Okay, so assimilation is the process of making different types of protein in our body. Okay, in the cells, glucose breaks down with the help of oxygen into carbon dioxide and water. Okay, what happens in the cells? Glucose breaks down with the help of oxygen into carbon dioxide and water, and in this process what happens, bacho? Energy is released. So this all process takes place in the cell for the production of energy, and glucose is a nutrient being absorbed from our small intestine. Okay, that is the digested part. So you can understand the importance of nutrients and food. So the food that remain undigested and unabsorbed enters into the large intestine. Okay, after the absorption, whatever is left in the small intestine, that is being transported to the large intestine, and large intestine is the next compartment in our digestive system. So I am so going to show you the large intestine, then we will discuss. Okay, so this structure, this complete structure, okay, which I am showing you, is called large intestine. Okay, and here you can see the attachment of small intestine with the large intestine. Okay, and here the undigested food moves upward, then parallel, then downward. Okay, so come to the chapter lines. Here, large intestine. The large intestine is wider and shorter than small intestine. As you have seen, it is wider and shorter, and it is about 1.5 meter in length. The length of the large intestine is 1.5 meter, and its function is to absorb water and some salt from the undigested food material. Okay, So lastly, water and some other salts are being absorbed from large intestine. After that, what happens? The remaining waste passes into the rectum and remains there as semi-solid feces. Okay, I am going to show you the rectum where the left part is stored. Here, this is up to large intestine. Here, this region is called rectum. Okay, and rectum is the region compartment where undigested semi-solid undigested food is stored. Okay, then what happens? The fecal matter is removed through the anus from time to time. This is called egestion. Okay, so whatever is left, semi-solid feces, that is stored in the rectum, and this feces is removed through the anus time to time. Okay, as you know, you all are doing it. So this is called egestion, and I am going to show you the anus from where the fecal matter is released. Here, this ending part of the large intestine is called anus, and that helps in the release of fecal matter, that is the undigested food. Okay, so this is all about the digestive system of human being. But you all recall your knowledge, please, and get to know about the various compartments of the digestive system of human being. We have started from the buccal cavity, then oesophagus, then stomach, then large intestine, then small intestine, then large intestine. Okay, and along with them there were some glands, and among them the major gland is liver, then pancreas. Okay, now we will study digestion in grass eating animals. Okay, how digestion takes place in grass eating animals, we will learn here. Have you observed cows, buffaloes and other grass eating animals chewing continuously even when they are not eating? Okay, actually they quickly swallow the grass and store it in the part of the stomach that is called rumen. Okay, what happens, bachcho? You have observed that cows and buffaloes and other grass eating animals, they are chewing continuously. Whenever, if you are belonging to the farmer family, you have seen that in the field buffaloes, cows and other grass eating animals are chewing continuously. Okay, without any break they are continuously chewing, and just they are storing their food to the special part of their stomach that is called rumen. Okay, I am going to show you the rumen. Here, this bigger compartment is called rumen. Okay, here the grass in the bolus form is stored. Okay, whenever you have seen that continuously grass eating animals are eating continuously, and they are storing all the food in the rumen. Okay, so this food is partially digested and it is called curd. Okay, whatever is stored in the rumen is partially digested and its name is curd. But later the curd return to the mouth in a small lump and the animal chew it. Okay, what happens, this food returns back after some time and this is being again chewed. You have seen that after fulfilling their stomach, these grass eating animals are sitting somewhere and just doing jugali. Okay, we are what is jugali? What happens in jugali? The small part of that curd, okay, returns back to the mouth, and that small lump animals, what they are doing, they are chewing again it, okay, and this process is called rumination. So rumination is what? Rumination is chewing of curd again in the mouth, okay, or returning of curd to the mouth is called chewing, okay. Returning of the curd to the mouth and chewing by animals is called rumination, okay. And these animals are called ruminants. So cows and other grass eating animals are called ruminants. Sorry, bachcho. The grass is rich in cellulose. As bachcho, we know that grass is rich in cellulose, and that is a very complex form of carbohydrate. Okay. In ruminants like cattle and deer, bacteria present in rumen help in the digestion of cellulose. Okay, you know that in the rumen, what is there present? Bacteria are present. So, bachcho, they have a special type of bacteria in their rumen which help in the digestion of the cellulose. Okay, many animals, including humans, cannot digest cellulose. Why we can't digest cellulose? Because we don't have rumen like structure, and we don't have those bacteria which are present in the rumen for the digestion of cellulose. Okay, so animals like horses, rabbits, etc. have a large sac structure called cecum. Okay, in place of what? In place of rumen, they have cecum. Okay, between the esophagus and the small intestine. Okay, here at the same place where rumen is present in horses and rabbits, the large sac-like structure is called cecum. Okay, and that is present between the esophagus and the small intestine, and its location is exact same as the location of rumen. The cellulose of the food is digested here by the action of certain bacteria which are not present in humans. Okay, so because of these bacteria, these animals are able to digest grass and other cellulose food, and we can't. Next, after studying this digestion special structure in the grass eating animals, we will learn a special single cellular an animal that is called amoeba, and we will learn feeding and digestion in amoeba. So look here, bachcho. Amoeba is a microscopic single celled organism found in pond water. Okay, if you have microscope, otherwise if you have you in your school laboratory, you will find microscope and just bring some pond water and observe under the microscope, you will get to know, you will be able to observe the amoeba. And amoeba is what? It is a single cellular organism, means all the function, digestion, assimilation, excretion, okay, these all things are being done by a single cell. Okay, so amoeba has a cell membrane around it, dense nucleus and many small bubble like vacuoles. Observe here, this is cell membrane, this is nucleus, and these are different types of organelles. Okay, or different types of organelles. And here the feeding habit, you see here, there is a special type of shape is formed in cell membrane of amoeba, that is called pseudopodium, and that help in ingestion of food particle, and these food particles get inside the cell and covered by a digestive organelle, okay, where digestive juice is formed. After digestion, that is egested, okay, the undigested part is egested outside. Okay, so what happens here? Amoeba constantly changes its shape and position. Okay, amoeba moving at any time. Okay, it pushes out one or more finger like projection, that is called pseudophobia. Okay, so what I told you earlier, that in amoeba, that finger like structure is projection is formed for taking the food inside, that is called pseudopodia, and pseudopodia also help in the movement of the amoeba. Okay, so amoeba, this pseudopodia help the amoeba in taking food, and this pseudopodia is also called false feet, and it help in the movement and capturing of food. Here in this picture you can observe how amoeba is capturing its food and moving the captured food inside their body, and digestion takes place. Okay, so amoeba feeds on some microscopic organisms. Okay, it's very small. Already amoeba is a microscopic organism, and amoeba feed in more microscopic organisms. Okay, when it senses food, it pushes out pseudopodia around the food particle and engulf it. Okay, here you can observe, whenever amoeba feels somewhere food, it just makes its pseudopodium and engulf the food particle. The food particle becomes trapped in food vacuole. Here this is food vacuole where food particle is trapped. Okay, and food vacuole has what? Digestive juice are secreted into the food vacuole, and it help in the digestion of food. And what happens? Food particle breaks down in simpler substances, and that is being absorbed and utilized by amoeba for their growth, maintenance and multiplication. Multiplication means increasing their numbers. And after the digestion, undigested residue of the food is expelled outside by the vacuole. So this is the food vacuole. After digestion, this residue food is being expelled out by vacuoles. Okay, so the basic process of digestion of food and release of energy is the same in all organisms. Okay, main thing is what? Breaking down of complex food substances into simpler form, and this happens in all the organisms of this world. Okay bachcho, so please recapitulate what we have studied today. Okay, we have studied about the other compartments of the digestive system in human being. After mouth and buccal cavity, we have studied about oesophagus. Then we get to know about stomach, then small intestine, then absorption. We get to know how absorption takes place in small intestine. Then we came to large intestine, and large intestine the last compartment of digestive system in human being. After that, we have studied about the grass eating animals. Okay, and here we get to know about the shape of human, how digestion and excretion take place in grass eating animals. And lastly, we have studied about the single cellular organism amoeba, that how the digestion takes place in these single cellular organisms. Okay bachcho, so please I request you all to see this video 2-3 times, and whenever you find difficulty, please write in comment box if you have any problem. Otherwise, just pause the video and learn all the things step by step, okay, by taking time. Okay, thank you bachcho. In the next video I will discuss about the keywords, and we'll also recapitulate the whole chapter. Okay, and after that we will do the exercise. So bachcho, be with me. If you are new in the channel, please subscribe this channel, so that whenever the next video will be uploaded, you will get the notification. Okay, and as usually I am uploading the new video every alternate day. Okay, every alternate day in the morning at 6 o'clock. Okay, so bachcho, please visit my channel 6 o'clock in alternate day in the morning, so that you will get to know about the next video. So thank you bachcho, thank you very much for seeing the video, and I am trying to help you all in this lockdown period to study well. Okay, so thank you बच्चों, मिलते हैं फिर next video में नए कैनल हमारे जो left part है उसको पढ़ने के लिए. Okay, so thank you very much once again. Bye bye.